It's no secret at this point that rap music is probably the most demonic people on earth. Some of the stuff we hear about in lyrics, from, you know, them targeting each other, unconfirmed murders, rappers constantly threatening each other with things like, "I'ma kidnap your mom" or something. Even my favorite rapper, Lil Wayne, has a bar about that. "I don't give a motherfuck, get your baby kidnapped, and your baby motherfuck kidnap his mom. And fuck her like Stiflis. Get his mama addressed and send his parents his head." So this got me to wondering, what's the worst thing that a rapper has ever said in a song? And that's what this video is about. We're gonna be looking at what are the worst things rappers have said in their rap songs, whether it's from the past or recently. Let's just take a look. So we're starting with Biggie, the notorious B.I.G. This man released this song called "What's Beef" in the year 1997. This is the era in which Biggie was starting to beef a lot with Tupac, and apparently was getting sick and tired of all the beef that was happening around this time, saying that, you know, why are you beefing in the songs? Why aren't we not meeting in the streets and, you know, doing the actual deeds with, like, sticks and stones? You know what I mean? Blickies, nines, I don't know, all that stuff. But then in the song, he has a very, very controversial line, which is very questionable, very, very messy. I don't know. We're gonna play it and you're gonna hear it. "Don't they know my nigga gotta fucking kidnap kids? Fuck them in they ass, throw them over the bridge." Bro, 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 what? What? All right. How is that your nigga? Like, realistically, how is that your nigga? Like, how is he your nigga and this is what he does and you're just like, "That's my nigga, he does that." What? Now, it's important to note that Biggie died soon after this song was released. So, like, literally within weeks, this song was check this out. Biggie died on March 9, 1997. The song was released on March 25, 1997. This means that he died literally while they were producing the song. Maybe it was literally ready to be released. So yeah, I guess he was in a demonic space during the time because, you know, the energy was strong. And yeah, this is what happens. This is what happens, I guess. I don't know, man. Don't do this stuff. Don't sing about this. Jesus. Now, this next one is also super unhinged. It's from a rapper named DMX. I'm sure you guys know him. Back then, man, I don't know what was happening. He was a complete demon, bro. This song is from 1998. Why are all the niggas from the 90s so crazy, bro? I don't know what was happening in the time. These people, they were on absolute demonic energy. And it all involves minors for some reason, you know? Why? So I'm gonna let the song play and I'm gonna let you guys hear this for yourselves. "And if you got a daughter older than 15, I'm a raper. Take her on the living room floor, right there in front of you." Bro, why? Why?
Why? Why?
Oh my god. I can't justify this, you know, because these guys are legends and we're supposed to respect them. But what the hell? Why? I don't know why it was against the minors either. I don't know why they're not just, like, going at their person. Why do they have to sing this? It's confusing. I don't know. All right, so now we're moving away from the super dark stuff that is targeting minors or, you know, centered around those people. And let's move into the just unhinged stuff. It's already unhinged. Now we're moving to the slightly less unhinged stuff, but still unhinged. So the next one is by an artist named Danny Brown, and we're going to be looking at his song called "Torture." You know, the title speaks for itself. Whole song is dark, but the beginning really does set the mood. It really makes you think, like, what the hell? Let's go ahead and play it. "Put peanut butter on her pussy, let his pits lick it off." Now you see, that's already an unhinged line. Your song is called "Torture," and you know you're talking about this torturous stuff. Like, what's this is basically bestiality, my bro. What's happening? Now it's important to say that this man, most of his songs are like this. He's a person who sings about dark stuff, but you know, that's not really a justification. I don't know why this has to be your content, bro. You could have rapped about anything and you're coming at it like this. I don't know. Now, the next one, we're going to be talking about Eminem. Everybody knows Eminem was crazy back in the day. Like, he was actually quite insane. Some of the stuff he did was actually just super insane. "Come here, little kitty, on my lap." Like, the man wrote a whole diss track against his own mom, you know? So that speaks for itself right there. "I bet you're probably sick of me now, ain't you, mama? I'ma make you look so ridiculous now. I'm sorry, mama." Okay, this one is a bit more understandable because his dad abandoned him when he was a child and then his mom turned to drugs. So maybe that was him just lashing out. But then there's the other stuff. Like this clip right here at the Grammys or whatever award show this was.
"When are we going to make a movie together? No. I'll set up the tripod and make sure the night vision is on. Oh, baby, yes. Oh, baby."
Just thinking on the backlash this man would have received if he did this today is crazy. So the song we're going to be talking about here is called "Insane" by Eminem, and it was made in 2009. It literally starts with him just going crazy.
I was born with a dick in my brain. Yeah, fucked in the head. My stepfather said that I sucked in the bed. So one night he snuck in and said, we're going out back. I want my dick sucked in the shed.
Shady, shady. Why? All right. So yeah, there you go, Eminem, you know, this guy's been crazy since a long time ago, but holy fuck, bro, holy shit, okay, Jesus, alright, and the next one is again by Eminem. We're just gonna talk about Eminem right now, because that's what he's on. This man was crazy, bro. This song called Kim, I don't know if anyone knows it. The song was released in 2000, it was written in 1998, so again, we're back to the 90s, but you know, Eminem transcends that, because he has that other song, which was from 2009, and he's still going crazy. This man is unhinged, and he's always been unhinged. Bro, it's crazy. So this one is not as wild as the other one, but it's still pretty wild. It's still pretty crazy. Check it out.
Don't make me wake this baby. She don't need to see what I'm about to do. Quit crying, bitch. Why you always make me shout at you?
So yeah, this song as a whole is just super unhinged. It's just talking about crazy things. I'm not gonna play the whole thing because of copyright, but you're just gonna have to go look for the song for yourself. It's another crazy one by Eminem. It's just not as crazy as the other one. So, but he was a crazy man, and this is what it probably still is, actually, because you can't be singing this shit. Now, this next one is, it shouldn't be funny, but I find it extremely goofy because it's Rick Ross. We all know he would have never done that shit. Rick Ross lies about being a super gangster, like his background as a gangster. Everybody knows he stole the name from that other actual Rick Ross who's in jail. The guy came out complaining.
He just saw a hot name, you know what I'm saying? He thought it was abandoned. You know, he thought I was going to get a life sentence I had a life sentence, so he thought I was never getting out. So he just made himself helpful to him.
So when I see lyrics like this coming from Rick Ross, it's just really goofy to me. I don't know why he thought this was a good angle to go for, but it's from a song called Uwe Uwano. I don't know how to spell that shit or how to say it. I don't even know what it means. I don't know, bro. It was a collab with Future and an artist named Rocco, and this is what Rick Ross said.
Put Molly all in her champagne. She ain't need no. I took her home and I enjoyed that. She ain't need no.
Bro. Why? Oh my god. Yeah, that's Rick Ross for you guys. 2013, Rick Ross went wild. I don't know why, but this man just thought this was a good idea. And he basically talked about a date, BAPE. I'm going to take that from Blackie Speaks. He doesn't say the full word. He says BAPE. So I'm going to start doing that now. BAPE. So yeah, he's singing about this shit. Rick Ross, everybody. The alleged gangster or whatever. All right. So my boy Future released a song in 2017, was it? Yeah, 2017. He made a song with The Weeknd. Called Coming Out Strong, okay? And there's this lyric right here. I love this so much, bro. This is the goofiest shit. So this is what he said.
The only time I feel alive when I taste it.
Bro, he said it. I don't know. If you go on Genius and you look at the lyrics, where is it? Look at this lyric on Genius here. The only time I feel alive when I take, and then they put a still coming in the... Bro, that's not what he said. Listen to this.
Don't got it, they make one. The only time I feel alive when I taste it.
That's not what he said. You liars. You actual... Bro. Okay, you know what the funny part is? Bro, Kodak actually called him and asked him about this. Check it out.
I gotta hit him up and ask him this question and shit. I'm doing it on live. I probably shouldn't even did this on live. Yo. Hey, bro. Hey, I'm listening to this song, dog. A nigga fuck was just so tough, homie. What did you say this part right here, bro?
What you said right there? The only time I feel alive when I take.
What the
when
fuck?
When you take.
Yeah, like, I take a pill. Only time I feel alive.
You ain't said that.
Take. Yeah, what it.
Bro, he didn't say that. Hey, listen. Future knows what he said, bro. Hey. Oh my god. I need to find out if Future ever hung out with Diddy when he was coming up, because, yeah. Bro, it's strong. But yeah, man, that's it for this video. This is my first ever commentary video. Let me know, you guys, what you think, if I should keep making videos like this. Let me know what you guys think in the comments, whether what topics you would like me to cover, what else to do, if I'm doing a great job, if there's any way I could improve. Because, yeah, I really could use all the advice right now. Just let me know anything you think, whatever it is. Leave it in the comments below. And we're a small channel, so I would appreciate a like and a comment, even a dislike. It all goes to the algorithm. So please give me feedback, guys. As much feedback as you possibly can. Thank you for watching up to here where you are. Thanks for watching. Leave a like, subscribe. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And with that being said, peace, guys. See y'all in the next video.